Hello everyone, in this tutorial we'll learn how to quickly create screen shake using Cinemachine. No code is needed. I will assume that you know something about Cinemachine and how to add virtual cameras. If you don't know, you can check the Unity 2D Master course on Udemy. It's beginner friendly and you will learn everything you need to start making 2D games. The link with the discount code applied is in the description. Let's get back to screen shake. I will create a screen shake when the player collects the gem and when he destroys the box. First, select your virtual camera, then add one extension. We need Cinemachine Impulse Listener. This component will listen for screen shake impulses in the game. This is a 2D game, so use 2D distance. Next, select the gem, add component, search for Cinemachine Collision Impulse Source. This will trigger a screen shake when objects collide. Next, we need a signal for the impulse source. Create new noise settings. This will be gem screen shake. Select noise settings. Now we can adjust screen shake for each axis. Select the X axis and click on the plus button to add frequency and amplitude. Frequency is how fast the screen will shake and amplitude is the strength of the shake. Let's add some numbers. You can add multiple frequencies and amplitudes. Then add numbers for y-axis. For 2D games, you don't want to use z-axis. Also, if you need, you can change rotation. Now select the gem. In the impulse source settings, you can adjust all amplitudes and frequencies of the signal. Then you can adjust fade in and fade out times of screen shake using time envelope. The attack is fade in into the shake. I will set this to 0.1 seconds and adjust the graph. Sustain time is the duration of the shake on maximum strength. Decay is fade out time. The next important setting is to choose what layer will trigger the shake when objects collide. For layer mask, choose the player. Make sure that the player is on that layer. Let's try it. Great. This screen shake will work for 2D and 3D games. Now let's use a bit of coding to create another shake when we destroy the box. Let's select the box. This time add impulse source without collision. Again, you can create another signal specific for the box, but in this example I will use gem signal. I will not change any options. Go to the box script. This script is from the 2D Master course. We use inheritance and virtual functions. This function is called when the box is destroyed. Inside that function, we need to start screen shake. First, import the Cinemachine namespace. Then create impulse source variable. In the start function, get component so we can get access to properties and functions. In the destroy function, use impulse source to call generate impulse function. That's all we need to code. Let's try it. Destroy the box so we can see the screen shake. Nice. Thank you for watching and see you next week.